Hello viewers, Assalamu Alaikum. I am Dr. Ghazi Muhammad Zakir Hossain, Associate Professor Surgery, Basundhara Ad-Din Medical College. I welcome you all in the following lecture class. Today we shall discuss about hemorrhoid. It is an important perianal condition. Patient presents with perirectal bleeding. Now, what is hemorrhoid? Hemorrhoid can be defined as a dilatation, ptosity, and elongation of the blood vessel, especially blood vessel vein, which draining the rectum and anal canal. That is dilatation, elongation, and ptosity of the veins that draining the rectum and anal canal. The word hemorrhoid derives from hem and rods. Hema means blood, rod means following. That is, the blood is following. Another name is hemorrhoid is piles. It is a Latin word derived from pila. Pila means a ball. So, in our country it is also known as piles. Piles and hemorrhoid is synonymously used as a condition, as a disease of the anorectal region. How hemorrhoid developed? All of you know that the blood vessel supplying or draining the rectum and anal canal, there are important structure known as anal cushion. These are the aggregation of the blood vessel and a smooth muscle and connective tissue in the submucosa of the anus and rectum. When this anal cushion descends down, then the hemorrhoid develop. What is the position of the anal cushion? There are primary position and secondary position of the anal cushion. Primary anal cushion is in three position: 3 o'clock, 7 o'clock, and 11 o'clock position in the anus, when the patient is in lithotomy position. When we examine the patient in lithotomy position, then the primary hemorrhoidal site can be seen in the 3, 7 and 11 o'clock position. That is left lateral, right posterior and right anterior position, 3, 7 and 11 o'clock position. In other places, in between, hemorrhoid can also be developed. That is known as secondary position or secondary hemorrhoid. Now, what is the classification of type of hemorrhoid? It may be internal hemorrhoid, it may be external hemorrhoid, or it may be interno-external hemorrhoids, both together. Internal hemorrhoid develops above the pectinate line, external hemorrhoid develops below the pectinate line. Now, internal hemorrhoid, that is the prolapse of rectal mucosa along with the blood vessels, that is the anal cushion, is known as, it can be divided into primary hemorrhoid and secondary hemorrhoid. When the hemorrhoid develops in 3, 7 and 11 o'clock position, when the patient is in lithotomy position, it is known as primary hemorrhoid. Secondary hemorrhoid located in between the primary position. Primary internal hemorrhoid occurs as a result of shearing forces acting on the anus, leading to caudal displacement of the anal cushion and mucosa. Primary hemorrhoid results from shearing of forces acting on the anal, leading to caudal displacement of the anal cushion and mucosa. Primary hemorrhoid results from unknown causes. They may disappear without treatment. What are the theories of development of hemorrhoid? That is the dietary and stool incontinency, anal hypertonia, aging of the patient, vascular causes, portal hypertension, even varicocel, and infection in the anorectal region. These are the causes of development of anal hemorrhoid. Other causes of internal hemorrhoids includes local anorectal deformity, hypotonia is of the sphincter, abdominal, intra-abdominal causes such as ascites, pelvic causes, gravid uterus, uterine neoplasm, carcinoma rectum, neurological causes such as paraplegia and multiple sclerosis. These are the secondary cause of development of internal hemorrhoid. Now, for descriptive purpose, we divide the hemorrhoid into grading. That is the grade 1, grade 2, grade 3 and grade 4. Grade 1, no prolapse, just prominent blood vessel only bleeds. Rectal, we can see it by proctoscopy. That is the rectal bleeding only. There is no prolapse, but prominent blood vessel can be seen through the proctoscope. Grade 2, prolapse on shearing or bearing down spontaneously reduces, bleeding occurs. That is the grade 2, prolapse during straining, prolapse during defecation or straining. Prolapse during defecation and straining, it is only grade 2. Prolapse during straining down and it can be manually repositioned, can be done. That is known as grade 2. Prolapse of the rectal mucosa along with the blood vessel, that is the hemorrhoid, and it can be manually repositioned, can be done, that is known as grade 3. And grade 4, when the permanently become prolapse, it cannot be manually reduced, that is known as grade 4. So, in short, grade 1, only bleeding. Grade 2, prolapse but reduced spontaneously. Grade 4, grade 3, prolapse but can be reduced manually. And grade 4, there is prolapse of mucosa and that is the prolapse of hemorrhoid that cannot be reduced manually. That is the permanently reside in outside. Now, what is the diagnostic criteria or how can you diagnose the case of hemorrhoid, that is the clinical feature. Most of the patient come to us with rectal bleeding. There is a characteristics feature of rectal bleeding in case of hemorrhoid. That is the patient comes with painless rectal pararectal bleeding, that is flushes the pain. Occasionally patient may come with bleeding drop by drop after defecation. And patient may develop anemia due to massive loss of blood per rectum, through the rectum. This is the, in case of hemorrhoid, patient bleeds pararectomy, pararectal bleeding occur, it is painless and trophic amount of bleeding just like a flush or just like occasionally drop by drop bleeding can occur, and patient may complains of irritation in the perianal region which is produced due to discharge of mucus and perianal discomfort. Patient may present with prolapse of the rectal mucosa which may comes in the anal margin and spontaneously reduce, but occasionally patient may present in the late stage, patient may present with a lump or a swelling which cannot be reduced inside the anal region. So, in clinical presentation, patient presents with pararectal bleeding, irritation, prolapse mucosa or prolapse of something or something coming down through the anus into the outside the perianal region. Now, what is the complication of hemorrhoid? It may be strangulated, there may be thrombosis of the blood vessel, ulceration, gangrene, portal pyemia and fibrosis, and patient may present with severe hemorrhage leading to anemia and shock. Now, what are the investigation we can do for the diagnosis of hemorrhoid or piles? No laboratory investigation is necessary for the diagnosis. only physical examination, that is the per rectal examination, is enough for the diagnosis of hemorrhoid. Per rectal digital examination is done to rule out the carcinoma of the rectum. Hemorrhoid cannot be felt unless it is thrombosed or it is fibrosed. Hemorrhoid can be seen through the proctoscope. On proctoscopic prolapse of the prolapse lump seen in the proctoscope, it is cherry red in color. Flexible sigmoidoscopy and colonoscopy can be done to diagnose or to exclude the colorectal cancer. So, for diagnosis, we can do digital rectal examination and proctoscopy and flexible sigmoidoscopy and colonoscopy. Now, regarding treatment, we can divide it into conservative treatment and surgical treatment. Conservative treatment is essential or it enough for the treatment of first degree and second degree hemorrhoid. That is dietary modification, that is fiber rich diet, normalizing the bowel habit, defecation habit, only evacuation when the nature desire to do so, appropriate defecation position, and addition of stool softener and bowel forming agent. This is only necessary for the treatment of first degree hemorrhoid. In case of second degree hemorrhoid, we can give sclerotherapy, that is the submucosal injection of 5% phenol in almond oil is enough for the treatment of second degree hemorrhoid. Now, in case of second degree and hemorrhoid, we can advise bending, Baron bending. Band is applied in the neck of the hemorrhoid and it gradually sloughing up at the within 10 days. And main disadvantage of Baron bending is chance of bleeding. Other methods, cryotherapy, infrared photocoagulation, these are not open use nowadays. Now, surgery. What is the indication of surgery in case of hemorrhoid? Third and fourth degree hemorrhoid all are treated with surgery. Second degree hemorrhoid that does not respond with the non-operative treatment, that is sclerotherapy and dietary modification, can be a candidate for surgery. Fibrous hemorrhoid is also indication for surgery. When the patient presents with anemia, any degree, all cases of hemorrhoid hemorrhoid are the candidate for the treatment of surgery. Before surgery, you have to prepare the patient, that is, no food per oral, taking stool softening for days before surgery, pre-operative enema to clean the rectum, general or regional anesthesia, patient should be in lithotomy position or jackknife position, and shaving of the perianal region. Then, surgery, we can do open surgical technique, ligation and excision of the hemorrhoid, and mucosa is open. Another is closed technique, that is the Hill-Ferguson technique, that is the closed technique, ligation, excision of the hemorrhoid, and wound is sutured. Now, the modern technique developed for the treatment of hemorrhoid, where there is two or more hemorrhoid develops, more than one develops, it is staple hemorrhoidopexy, that is known as Longo procedure. Circular stapler is used to treat the cases. Now, what is the complication in the post-operative period of hemorrhoidectomy by hemorrhoidal surgery? Early complication and late complication. Early complication, pain due to surgery and acute retention of urine, that may be hemorrhage, that is the reactionary hemorrhage. Late complication is secondary hemorrhage, anal stricture, anal fissure, and incontinence of stool and feces. That is all. Thank you all.